Wondering how residential and ISP proxies compare? After all, both proxy types hide your IP address. So what's the difference? And why should you choose one over another? Let's find out. Residential proxies are IP addresses owned by internet service providers and assigned to real people. Their computers, phones, or any other smart devices connected to Wi-Fi. The way residential proxies hide your IP is simple. Instead of sending the connection request directly to your wanted website, you send the request to a proxy server, which then routes the request through a residential device and then connects to the website. Because of this, residential proxies have many strengths. Differently than data center or ISP proxies, resis rarely share the same subnet. So you can forget accidentally blocking a bunch of IPs at once. And get this, residential proxy providers control thousands or even millions of different IP addresses. That's why you'll hardly get the same IP address twice. You'll also be able to select IP addresses pretty much anywhere in the world. Most importantly, a residential proxy is hard to block. Since it's hosted on a real device, the IP looks like a regular user. However, these proxies are several times slower than data center or ISP addresses. That's because they rely on the internet quality of end users and add an extra element to the connection path. Also, resis aren't a good choice if you need to keep the same IP for a long time. Even if the provider offers a sticky session of 10 or more minutes, end users can disconnect at any moment. And then there's the whole sharing aspect. Residential proxy providers give all customers access to the same proxy pool. That means you're gonna share those IPs with others. What's wrong with that, you ask? Watch our video about the difference between private and shared proxies to find out. Getting back to residential proxies though. So, all things considered, when should you choose this type of proxy? First, if you need to access well-protected websites. That would be social media platforms, sneaker stores, and highly scraped sites like Wayfair. Second, residential proxies are very helpful if you need to view localized content or work with multiple locations at once. I'm talking location-sensitive tasks like ad verification or SEO monitoring, which sometimes even require such features as city-level targeting. But enough about resis. What about ISP proxies? Are they a better option? ISP, or static residential proxies, attempt to combine the best qualities of data center and residential proxies. Like residential proxies, they're owned by internet service providers and not web hosting services. Like data center proxies, they're hosted on servers at data centers without involving end users. What this means is that ISP proxies don't need to rely on iffy end-user connections. These IPs are fast, stable, and always available on demand. They're also relatively hard to detect. It's because ISP proxies are owned by internet service providers, which have a much better reputation than cloud hosting services. On top of that, some ISP proxy providers offer unlimited traffic plans. This is very useful when carrying out data-intensive activities. But let's be real, ISP proxies are not perfect either. Just like with data center proxies, it's hard to get IPs in a wide range of countries. So ISPs will give you fewer locations to choose from than resis. It's also hard to get big commercial ISPs on board, so many of the IPs end up registered with small, regional companies. IP databases often identify them as data center IPs, which negates the main benefit of ISP proxies. Besides, ISP proxies can't escape one of the downsides of data center IPs. They're simply too organized. Having neat IP ranges sacrifices diversity, so you're still at risk of getting your whole subnet banned. Then, when should you choose ISP proxies over residential? When performing traffic-intensive tasks, definitely. A good example would be sneaker copying. Since you can buy ISP proxies by IP address, you won't have to pay extra for bandwidth. ISP proxies are also the best pick when it comes to protected websites that require a consistent identity. What would that be? Facebook and Instagram are a few examples. That's why multiple social media account management often relies on the help of ISP proxies. Already know which type you like better? If so, here are the videos that will help you choose the best providers of residential and ISP proxies. Click to watch and sleep soundly, knowing damn well you made the right purchase. See you there.